Hello students, now we will look into difference between disc brake and drum brakes. So as you can see here, this is a typical drum brake, and here you can see the brake lining. These are the brake lining, means that is the friction material, shaded one. These are the anchors. This is the retractor spring. This is called as brake shoe. On brake shoe, this liner is riveted. This is a brake drum. So this brake shoe is pressing against the brake drum is rotary. This, when the brake shoes expand due to application of force, now here when there is the application of force, this will expand and this brake lining will resist the movement of the brake drum. So this is a typical brake drum brakes. So when the hydraulic oil pressure or pneumatic air pressure comes, this expands against the retractor spring. So when you leave the pedal, again it comes to normal position, and these are the friction material what you see. So this is the anchor which is holding both these brake shoe in place. Okay, now we will see drum brakes. Here see drum brakes, we see disc brakes. Here you can see the disc brake. This is known as caliper, and this is a revolving disc. Okay. So for this, this B is the friction pad. So this friction, due to this oil pressure coming here, this will press the piston. So when the piston moves inside, both of them move inside. You can see the ventilated disc here. This is how the drum brake. So now we let us see the difference between the disc brake and drum. Disc brakes are more efficient cooling, whereas this is enclosed. Drum brakes is enclosed in the brake drum, so less efficient cooling. The heat has to be conducted through the drum, reducing the cooling rate. Here only the disc makes contact with the friction pad, and the remaining portion is directly exposed to the cooling air. As flat friction pads are used, wear on the friction surface is more uniform. Here the friction pads, you have seen, they are very flat. Here they are semi-circular friction lining, and the brake shoe results in non-uniform wear of the friction surface. Disc brakes weight is less, resulting in lower inertia. Here the weight is more due to the various components. Disc brakes are more stable and drum brakes are relatively less stable. Maintenance and service of brakes is easy. Here the drum has to remove, and also while replacing the brake lining, once the friction material gets worn out, it has to be dismantled, then they have to be riveted or fixed by using adhesives. It has better anti-fade characteristics. I explained to you about this anti-fading characteristics in disc brakes, whereas drum brakes are more prone to fading. These do not have self-servo action and hence require greater operating force. The brake shoe expresses self-energy and decreases the braking force required the pedal. Now that is why you have got power brakes also. Total friction area available is less, total friction area available is more. But efficiently, nowadays you can see that high speed bikes, cars and all, they are all going in for disc brakes, not drum brakes. So just if you look at again disc brakes, various configurations. Here you can see the cam operated disc drum brake. It is. Yeah, how it looks in real life. This is a disc. This is a rotating disc here, ventilated disc. Is shown here, ventilated caliper, and this is the hub and the brake lining. The color picture here, you can see the ventilated disc here. Here you can see the oil comes from here. The oil pushes this piston because the oil is compressed, it moves the piston. Here the friction pad comes in contact with.